Hey guys, it's Ben the Coin Geek at Old Pueblo Coin, which with something that promises to be the most boring video of all time. Generally speaking, I am not a coin roll hunter, but occasionally at a coin shop, you get something in and your curiosity just gets the best of you. For those of you who don't know, there are varieties on the Wisconsin quarter that make them a little bit more valuable. When these coins were first found, and they were first found here in Tucson, by our customer Bob Ford, and we went through them all with him, and it was pretty amazing time. I mean, the coins went crazy. They went from just a few bucks. I remember paying $5 each for them. I still have my original coins from him that I got for $5 each. I actually got them certified that way. So anyway, but those coins became real popular. They were on national TV. They were on the USA Today, which used to be a magazine that was super popular. And it's something that was really a fun time around these parts. It got crazy to the point where we were basically just taking phone call after phone call after phone call with people who wanted to buy these coins. So it was really something that was a strange bit of numismatic history to be a part of, because it became so popular nationally, and you were really able to see the power of the national media when you went through something like that, because they drove the price of these things, up to $700 or $800 per coin before you knew it. So. And eventually, high grade ones were selling for $1,500 or more. And it was really a crazy time. There were a couple of bank tellers who I think were able to pay for their entire college education, because once they figured out that the coins were available, they started going through the vaults themselves to find any rare ones, to find any of the highly promoted. And what's fun about this variety versus other varieties is they had both the high leaf and a low leaf variety and the regular variety. So far, these are all regular quarters. And the fact that there are three different varieties of this coin make it truly unique in the coin collecting world. Something else that makes it really unique is it's something that seems as though it was probably done at the mint intentionally by a mint employee. The mint has never really owned up to anything but saying, well, it was an accident. The dies just had the piece of metal struck in them. But it's virtually impossible to believe that you could have the coincidence of pieces of metal being put into exactly the right place to make extra corn leaves. All right, well, we're getting near the end of this group. It looks like we are in Dudsville, but that's okay. It's been a long, long time since I've gone through a roll of Wisconsin quarters, and even longer since I've gone through them and found any. So, for those of you who don't know the design, the general design is that right here on the corn, the leaf to the left of the corn and above the cheese wheel, there's no leaf on this one. This is the regular one. On the variety coins, there is a leaf, either the high leaf, which runs up and down this way, or the low leaf, which juts out over here, pointing down. And those are the two main varieties, and this is the regular coin. So, anyway, that is the Wisconsin quarter. And trust me, I went through thousands of these rolls, and I oftentimes had this exact same experience of finding nothing. So, thanks for watching. I'm Ben the Coin Geek. You can subscribe by clicking on the button in the corner and watch more videos on the right side of the screen. Thanks.